Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's take a look at doing a backup and restore of an iOS device. So if you have a problem with your iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch, you may get the advice to backup and restore it. You may get this device online, but you also may get it at the Genius Bar in the Apple Store. And this is kind of a complete reset of your iPhone. It resets it to factory settings and then it reinstalls all your stuff. So you should end up with the same stuff and the same settings as you did before, but kind of refreshes the entire iPhone. Now this may seem like a pretty heavy-handed fix, especially if you're only having minor problems. But it's really pretty simple. It just stores all of your stuff on your Mac, which you should be doing anyway in a backup, and then basically resets everything and puts everything back. It's pretty simple to do. It could take some time, but there's not really much that you have to do except set things in motion. So here I am in iTunes 11 and I've connected my iPhone with the dock cable. It's important to use the cable for this, not just rely on a Wi-Fi connection. Not all the functions will be there unless you have a cable attached. And I turn on the left sidebar, but if you don't have the left sidebar on an iTunes 11, you can also select your iPhone at the top of the screen. And then you'll get to this area here where you're viewing your iPhone and you've got things across the top like summary, info, apps, tones, etc. So you want to click on summary. And under a summary you'll see information about your phone listed, and also the next section is called backups. So now you know you're in the right place to do this. Now simply connecting your iPhone and running iTunes may have already started a sync and backup, but I always like to make sure. So I press the sync button that's usually at the bottom right corner. Now it says apply. And then after syncing I then do another backup by hitting the backup now button just to make sure I've got a good current backup. And it'll tell you the time of the backup right underneath there. Also I want to make sure that you back up to your computer, because it would be a lot faster if you use computer backup even if you're using iCloud backup normally. So switch to this computer and then do your backup. You can switch back to iCloud backups after you're done this process. Now, after it's completed its backup and you've synced and you are ready to restore your iPhone. So above you'll see under iPhone it'll have the version number you're running and check for update. Next to it that is Restore iPhone. So you want to click that button to start the process. Now you go through a series of dialog boxes including this one, and you may get more depending upon if you're also upgrading your iOS at this moment. So once you go through those it starts the process of clearing off your iPhone. And that process may take a while, so you may want to get a cup of coffee there. And it goes through several different stages. And once it's done you should end up back here, which is kind of a scary screen because you want your iPhone to be your old iPhone, not your new iPhone. But if you look there you can see you can set it up as a new iPhone, but also the default is restore it from a previous backup. And you have this pop-up menu of backups, and it should automatically have selected your latest backup. You can confirm it by looking at the time there. Then it starts the restore process. Now the actual restoring from backup is pretty quick, but that's because it doesn't include the apps. So the apps aren't your data. The apps are the apps. So you already have those in iTunes because you've been syncing. So what's going to happen now is it's actually going to reinstall all those apps. So that could take a while. For instance, I have a lot of apps on here. It takes up most of the space on my iPhone. So it's going to take a little while to put them all back on. And when you're finally done you get a screen like this, and it will take a little while more for it to basically restart and set it up so you see your iPhone in iTunes as before. Now what you should end up with more or less is your iPhone back the way it was. Settings will be restored, and that includes data saved by apps. So if you saved whether it's media files like pictures in Instagram, or it's just little bits of text and things in different types of apps, they should all be restored to what they were before. So your game saves and positions and all that should be back. Now it may not be perfect. For instance, if you had a security passcode set for your iPhone, you're going to have to reestablish that, and it'll prompt you for that. But more or less you should end up basically back with your iPhone. If somebody else did this for you, you may not even notice that it was done. So there's the basic steps for how to do a backup and restore of your iPhone or iPad or any iOS device. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.